inspiration is the fuel that powers us in life. Without it, a little obstacle seems like a mountain. And when we are inspired, the biggest mountain seems puny. As is the case of the lady, the first woman amputee of the world, who had an artificial leg and she scaled the highest mountain peak, that is the Everest. It's a very interesting story how it came about. Arunima Sinha was representing her state in the national volleyball competition to happen in Delhi. She was going by train from Bihar to Delhi to participate in the nationals. She was 24 years old. This was the month of November in the year 2011. At night, dacoits entered the train. They were looting in abandon. They wanted the golden chain on her neck. But being a fiery spirit, she resisted. And to teach a lesson to the other passengers, they took her and threw her out of the moving train. She fell onto the other track. Unfortunately for her, before she could gain her senses, a train went by and severed off one of her legs. In the morning, the villagers discovered her. The news was flashed in the national channels. There was a huge uproar around the country. She was airlifted to Delhi and treated in the All India Institute of Medical Sciences, where she was given an artificial leg. Arunima Sinha said, "This was unfortunate, but I will not let it get me down in life. I must still make my life a success. If not like this, then like that." Like children have toy cars, they reach an obstacle and then they go back a little and start moving in the other direction. Arunima Sinha was inspired by the Indian test cricketer Yuvraj Singh, who had got cancer but overcame it. She said, "What should I do to prove my worth?" The next year, Bachendri Pal, the first woman to climb Mount Everest, she was giving training in mountaineering. Arunima went there and took the classes. And then in May 2013, she was a part of a team that went up the peak. She describes that on the way, her leg got stuck in the snow. And the others had to hurry. So they were moving by the side. She just sat down there. She still persisted. She put it back and reached the peak. Subsequent to that, she started scaling the highest peaks in the different continents. And in 2015, she got the fourth highest civil award in India, which was the Padma Shri. Now look, despite being beaten, she still succeeded gloriously. And today she runs a non-profit school for the physically challenged. What was it that enabled her to blossom so well in life? It was her spirit, the inspiration from within. That is why somebody said, "You may lose everything in life but your enthusiasm, and you will gain it all back again." But that person who has lost his enthusiasm, now he is truly bankrupt. So in the side of material success, enthusiasm is so important. And when it comes to scaling spiritual heights, inspiration becomes the absolute foundation. The pillars on which the palace of bhakti stands are faith and inspiration, Shraddha एंड उत्साह. दैट इज व्हाई महर्षि पतंजलि, ही सेज देयर आर थ्री लेवल्स ऑफ साधक्स. मृदु मध्यादि मात्रत्वा ततोपि विशेषः. द मृदु आर दोज हु आर नॉट मोटिवेटेड इन देयर पाथ ऑफ साधना. दे एक्सपीरियंस लिटिल डिफिकल्टी एंड दे से नो, दिस इज नॉट फॉर मी. स्वामी जी, आई विल नॉट कम टू सत्संग एनी लॉन्गर. वाई? यू नो वॉट दैट पर्सन सेड दिस टू मी. सो वू, सच अ बिग डिफिकल्टी, दैट पर्सन सेड दिस टू यू. The kind of difficulties that the saints experienced and still kept going. Think of the energy they had to reach the goal. So then is the madhya. They will go with reasonable energy, but when the going gets tough, then they stop. And there are those tatopi visheshaha who are so inspired that they cut through this material energy maya like a knife cuts through butter. Similarly, Ramakrishna Paramhans said, enthusiasm is the key to success in spirituality. And Maharshi Patanjali says the same thing. Tivra samveganamasannaha, strive with all your energy. This inspiration, the mindset of enthusiasm, is then the key for material and spiritual success.